Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow.
Service, finally. I've been looking forward to this one. I don't know about you, but this year feels a bit different. Maybe we're just older. Maybe it's the weather. Or maybe it's two lockdowns saying we can't be together. Or growing fears and COVID tears in a US election that lasts for years. And masks, farces, and global marches and seemingly infinite TikTok dances. It's been quite a year by any metric you choose. We've all been exhausted, challenged and confused. At least we've still got Christmas to see us through. Then I saw the news and sure enough it's somehow cancelled too. So I thought about it for ages, for almost 15 seconds, and a Christmas revelation beckoned. This day's been celebrated for a couple thousand years. It's been banned, dictated, appropriated and feared. And somehow after all of that, it's led us here to our sofas. So relatively speaking, we've got it pretty good. I know that it's been hard, don't let me be misunderstood. But we're marked by hope, I know that when that is true, the world takes notice. Displaced Jewish couple traveling for miles. One probably terrified because the other was with child. Could they have expected everything that was to come? That one day a gangly Londoner would write songs about their son. The story is the same whether together or alone. Jesus born is killed for preaching love, then points us home. I guess if you're splitting hairs, there's more to it than that. But we're running out of time, so let's celebrate. Celebrated for a couple thousand years. It's been banned, dictated, appropriated and feared. But somehow after all of that, it's led us here to our sofas and beanbags and armchairs and futons. We sometimes forget the church is more than just a building. It's a global family of about 2 billion. And it's not where you are, it's and that was just fancy lights, mics, and Brian keeping time, which isn't even his name, I just changed it so it rhymed. Sorry, Tim. Don't let the beauty of the frame distract from what's inside it. Amazing grace sounds just as sweet however you find it. If you've not heard this story before, I think you're gonna lie.
As we come this morning, then it is the end of Advent, and so we started with hope, peace, joy, and love. And today, Christ our Saviour.
Amen.
On this day.
Yes.
We're going to sing Joy to the World, the Lord is Come. To the world. We're going to give thanks. I had Andrew down, but I think I'll have mercy on him and maybe ask Sonia to just do give thanks with us.
Yeah. Okay. So just sorting out my view. Sorry. Morning, church. Morning, morning. Morning, David. Morning, Joyce. Morning, Jeanette. Morning, Mo. Morning, Andrew. Morning, Dawn. So today is such a special day that giving thanks, we'll keep it short because we want it to be a short service, but whoever would like to give thanks, by all means, unmute yourself, give thanks, and then we'll close the give thanks in prayer. Jeanette, go ahead.
So of course I just want to give thanks for Jesus. I want to thank God for the most amazing gift and just the awe and the wonder of just like that little baby, which is the Son of God, and that all the angels would come down and just praise God. I heard recently that somebody said that it was like when the angel told the shepherds, all the other angels, they were desperate to see. This is the moment that the angel's going to say that God has sent Jesus. And they were all trying to have a look. And suddenly they all were pushing each other and they all fell out of heaven, thousands and millions of them. And they all just gave praise and thanks to God because they wanted to see this amazingly special moment when God saved the world through his precious Son. So God, I just want to praise you and thank you for your most amazing, amazing gift of Jesus and hope for everybody. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord, I want to thank you for family. I want to thank you for safety for us, Lord, physical, spiritual, and most of all, I just want to say thank you, Jesus. and just fill our hearts, God. Praise and thank you. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jeanette. Go ahead, Joyce.
I want to say thank you to Jesus. Happy birthday. May we praise you and bring joy to your name. Bring joy to you today. And we thank you that you love your glory in heaven to come to us to save us from our sins. Thank you, Jesus, for all you have done for us. Be with us today and forevermore. Be with our families, our friends and our church. And Lord God, may we love you and serve you and worship you. And thank you, Jesus, for all your love and your praise. Thank you for my family. Thank you for all the blessings that they bestow upon me. Please keep me safe in your arms and may I love and serve you all the days of my life. All glory be to you, Lord Jesus. I ask this in your holy name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Joyce. Lovely, beautiful. Anybody else want to give thanks at the minute?
I'd like to give thanks, Ron. I'd like to give thanks to see this day. You know, I think all adults have that little child inside them when it comes to Christmas Day. I look back at growing up as a young little girl and being so excited the night before. And I think as I've got older, I really understand the significance of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
We have been calling his name all year, going through so many different things, each and every one of us. And we just didn't realise just how precious this individual is for us. He's there for us 24/7. We call his name 24/7. And he'll continue being there for us 24/7. So Heavenly Father, we thank you for the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for letting us be honoured with his presence. And I hope and pray that we can continue to worship his name and continue to encourage others to know how wonderful a person your Son is. Lord, I thank you for all what we have done this year together as a community. And I pray for our leaders, David, Sonia and Andrew, who have continued tirelessly to continue keeping us afloat and keeping us going. And Lord, I thank you for them. I thank you for their families. And we thank you for them being able to do what they've done without any qualms. So Lord, we're giving thanks. We're giving thanks. We're giving thanks. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Dawn. Thank you very much.
Amen.
I'd like to give thanks. And again, I'd like to give thanks for this special day. It's been a fantastic day working towards it. I'm sure all of us have exhausted ourselves in peeling those Brussels sprouts and yam and green banana and all them type of things. I know I definitely have, but I'm looking forward to having a great day with my sister. It's going to be an emotional day for me. I don't know why, because I can feel myself getting all emotional now, but I just give thanks to God, thanks to Jesus for everything, and especially having my sister here. I know I said it earlier and I cannot find words to explain how the plan has just fallen into place. So yes, it's been a fantastic year in spite of the challenges. I know we haven't come to the end of the year yet, but this is the beginning of a new year. This is the day our Saviour was born. So this is a new year starting from today. So to give thanks to the church for the support that you've all given me, and may we continue to support each other, to share our love for each other that God has imparted in us as a church family. David, Joyce, Jeanette, Mo, Andrew, Dawn, I just really want to say thank you, and I love you all very much as individuals and as church family, and I give thanks and praise for that. So if there isn't anybody else, I'm just going to wrap this little bit up just with a very, very short prayer. My loving Lord, my heart bursts with joy as we are able to give you thanks and praise. And as you have blessed us, all we had to say was yes to your love, and that we have said. Dear Lord God, I lift this short prayer up to you, and I lift all the thanks, ones that have been shared and ones that have been kept in our hearts. I lift them up to you. Your name is to be sanctified. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
David, back over to you.
I found this version of this song. It unfortunately doesn't have all the lyrics, which is a bit of a shame, but it's great. We're going to sing again. Hark the herald angels sing. Just going to share just a short reflection, and I was reminded of a story, and I don't think I've told this at ABC before, but if I have then I have. And it's a story that about a man who didn't believe in God. He didn't recognize God being there, and he didn't hesitate to tell others how he felt about religion and about religious holidays. But his wife did believe, and she raised their children also to have faith in Jesus, despite all his comments. And one snowy evening, his wife was taking their children to a service in the little farm community in which they lived. And they were going to go and talk about Jesus' birth. And she asked him to come. But he refused. He said, that story's nonsense. Why would God lower himself to come to earth as a man? That's ridiculous. So she went off with the children and he stayed at home. And while they were gone, the winds got stronger and the snow turned from a little gentle flutter into a blizzard. And as the man looked out of the window, he saw in the blinding snowstorm that everything was getting covered. And he sat down to relax. Then he heard a loud thump and something had hit the window, and he looked out. He couldn't see very far, but as he went outside just to see what it was, in the field near his house, he saw a flock of wild geese, and they'd been flying south for the winter, but they'd been caught in this snowstorm and couldn't go in any further, and they got lost, and they were stranded on his farm with no food or shelter, and they were all just flapping their wings and flapping around in the field blindly and aimlessly. And a couple of them had flown into his window, and the man felt really sorry for the geese and wanted to help them. And he thought the barn would be a great place for them to stay. He thought, it's warm, it's safe. They could spend the night in there and wait out the storm. So he walked over to the barn and opened the doors wide and then watched and waited, hoping that the geese would just go in. But the geese just carried on fluttering around aimlessly and crashing into each other, and they didn't even seem to see the barn. And the man tried to get their attention, but he just scared them off and they moved further away. So he went in the house and he got some bread and made a sort of breadcrumb trail leading to the barn, and they still didn't figure it out. And he was getting frustrated, and he got behind them and tried to shoo them towards the barn, but they just got more and more scared, scattered in every direction apart from the barn. And nothing he could do could get them to go into the barn where they'd be warm and safe. And he thought, why don't they follow me? Can't they see this is the only place where they can survive this storm? And he thought for a moment, realised that if they just wouldn't follow a human. He thought to himself, if only I were a goose, I could save them. And then he had an idea, and he went into the barn and he got one of his own geese and he carried it in his arms and he circled round behind the flock of wild geese, and then he released it and his goose flew through the flock and straight into the barn, and one by one the other geese followed it to safety. And he stood silently for a moment as the words that he'd spoken a few minutes earlier played in his mind: if only I were a goose, then I could save them. Then he thought about what his wife had said earlier. Why would God want to be like us? That's ridiculous. Suddenly it all made sense. That's what God had done. We were like the geese, blind and lost and perishing. God had his son become one like us so he could show the way and save us. And as the winds and blinding snow died down, his soul became quiet. And he pondered this wonderful thought. Suddenly he understood why Christ had come. Years of doubt and disbelief vanished with the passing storm. And he fell to his knees in the snow and prayed his first prayer. Thank you, God, for coming in human form to get me out of the storm.
Amen.
I want to read from Gospel of John. This is from the Message version, which is really interesting for this. It says, the Word was first the Word present to God, God present to the Word. The Word was God in readiness for God from day one. Everything was created through him. Nothing, not one thing came into being without him. What came into existence was life, and the life was light to live by. The life light blazed out of the darkness. The darkness couldn't put it out. There was once a man, his name John, sent by God to point the way to the life light. He came to show everyone where to look, who to believe in. John was not himself the light. He was there to show the way to the light. The life light was the real thing. Every person entering life, he brings into light. He was in the world, the world was there through him, and yet the world did not even notice. He came to his own people, but they didn't want him. But whoever did want him, whoever believed he was who he claimed and would do what he said, he made to be their true selves, their child of God selves. These are God begotten, not blood begotten, not flesh begotten, not sex begotten. The word became flesh and blood and moved into the neighborhood. We saw the glory with our own eyes, the one-of-a-kind glory, like Father, like Son, generous inside and out, true from start to finish. The word became flesh and blood and moved into the neighborhood. I love this verse in this particular version. God became human and came to live amongst us. And that was the verse of Hark the Herald that was missed out, unfortunately. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see. Hail the incarnate deity, pleased as man with man to dwell. Jesus, our Emmanuel. Jesus was born as a human because God wanted a relationship with us. From the moment he created us, he wanted a relationship with us. Not some sort of third cousin twice removed who lives in Australia sort of relationship. God longs for a deep father-daughter, father-son sort of relationship with us. That's how he made us to be. That's how it originally was. We read in Genesis chapter 3, it says, "And they heard the sound of the Lord walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, 'Where are you?'" God wants to take a stroll with us, to chat with us, to laugh with us, cry with us. Before the fall, he did that because we were his perfect creation. And then we blew it. We fell for the devil's lies and we went our own way, and our sin separated us from God. But God still longed to have that intimacy once again, and so began his plan. And through the years, God tried talking to his people through prophets like Moses and Elijah, Isaiah and Jeremiah. But we just kept on disobeying, just kept on turning away from God. So he decided, "I'm going to come down to earth as a human. They'll understand a human. I'll send my son, Jesus Christ, and he'll tell them and show them how much I love them and want to save them from all the bad things in the world." And that's how much God loves us. He loves us so much that he gave up his wonderful life in heaven, where there's no sadness, no dying, no illness, no pain, no crying. And instead, Christmas, God came to earth as a baby, just like you and me were babies, helpless, weak, dependent. And then he grew and lived as a human so that Jesus could do and feel everything we do. He already understood what it is to be like, what it's like to be a human. But by doing this, he let us see that he understands. He let us see that he knows what we go through. In this world, there's not always a lot of hope, and 2020 has been the mother of all years for losing hope. But with Jesus, there's always hope. And that's why God was born as a baby, so we could see him face to face, so we could begin to get our heads round who he is. Perhaps the most famous verse in the Bible, John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." Advent, the time of preparation, is over. Christmas is here. Hallelujah. Amen. We've been on a journey of preparation, but the preparation's complete and today's the day. And that verse is part of a conversation Jesus has with the Pharisee Nicodemus, who, against the culture of his time and against his friends and colleagues, saw truth in Jesus and wanted to understand. And earlier on in that conversation, Jesus said to him, "I tell you the truth, no one can see the kingdom of God unless he's born again." You must be born again. And if that confuses you, then you're in good company. It confused Nicodemus, and it's confused many millions down the years. But that's the truth. And so, as we join together here at church this morning, if you're doing that because you think that out there's something, then welcome. If you're here because you like the comfort of carols and singing, then welcome. Church is a place to explore the mystery. It is a place to receive comfort. And everyone is welcome now and always. But on this day of good news to all mankind, the crescendo of God's plan to restore us into his family, I say again the words of our Saviour, Jesus, the baby in the manger that we celebrate. You must be born again. If we could get a glimpse of heaven today, we would hear the heavenly host singing, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favour rests." As we go about the rest of our day today, with presents and food, and if we're lucky, family, let's remember our God who came down as one of us. Jesus, our Emmanuel. Hark the herald angels sing, "Glory to the newborn King." Amen.
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 Amen. So as we draw this short service to a close, we're going to sing one more song, "O Come All Ye Faithful." So as we draw our service to a close, I'm going to ask Jeanette to close in prayer to lift up us and others this Christmas. Jeanette.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much just to come and worship you, to praise you and adore you, Lord. Yes. Blessed be your name. Yes. For such a privilege, for such a gift of love. And Lord, we think about our brothers and sisters, Christians around the world, Lord, who are suffering today because they love you, who are being tortured, who are being killed, who are separated from their loved ones for years on end. We think about the children, Lord, who are separated from their families, whose parents have died, and for the parents whose children have died because they love Jesus, because they know that your love and your truth is better than life. We just pray for them today. I pray your almighty protection upon them, God, in their homes, in the prisons, Lord, wherever they may be, in displacement camps, God. I just pray, and I pray your protection. I pray your blessing upon them, Father. I just claim by the authority you give me as your child, a co-heir of Christ, I claim protection upon them. Those who are able to have services, those who are at home, I pray, Lord, that you would protect them and they would be filled with the love and the beauty and the joy and the hope and the peace and the truth of Jesus. And Lord, we bring before you those who have been affected by COVID, those who are bereaved, those who have got the first time without their loved ones. We think of Irene and we think of Joan and Garfield, Lord, and we thank you for Barry and Mrs. Cole. Others, God, whose loved ones have gone. We just pray that they would know that their loved ones are with you. They are in that better place where there is no pain, no sadness, no death. And they're just having the greatest party on earth, but not on earth, the greatest party in heaven, Lord, celebrating Jesus, that most precious gift of God. God, we just pray for those who do have COVID. We pray for Dawn. We pray for Andrew. We pray for Mar Joseph, God, especially, and for Gary and all those, God, who've got COVID. We pray for their loved ones. We pray for total healing by your power, Father. Those in hospital, we pray for those who are tending them in hospitals, the NHS staff, care workers, those in care homes, the ambulance drivers, God, the paramedics, God. And I just pray, Lord, that people would be sensible today, that they would remember that we are still in a pandemic, God. And I pray for those who will be on their own, who might be feeling lonely. And I pray for a phone call or something, God, to bless them, to know your love. And I pray that somehow that they would just be filled with your love through a word, through a song, somehow, God. Be so close to them, even if I've never known you, Lord. I pray, Father, they would ask you into their hearts and minds, just like that man in the story who fell on his knees and realised you came to earth as a man. I just pray they'd know you, Lord. So, Father, we just bring all these things before you and we just worship you and we just say, thank you, thank you, thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So as we bring our short service, would you like to lead us in the grace, Dawn?
Give it my best shot.
Give me your best shot.
So may the grace of our Lord
Jesus
Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now
and
evermore.
Evermore.
Amen.
Amen.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Happy Christmas, everybody.
Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a happy new year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. So bring us pudding, bring us pudding, and a cup of good cheer.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas
and a Happy New Year
and a Happy New Year.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas
and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.